Dunkin' Donuts. Put the D at the end, you get unkind donuts, which I've had a few of in my day. My name is Merl Reagle. I'm a syndicated crossword puzzle constructor.
Well, Merl is a great guy. We've been friends for years. He's like me in many ways. He was a puzzle head from when he was a child. He started making crosswords when he was in his teens.
Normally, I'm either thinking of puzzles, or cluing them here, or cluing them there, or thinking of themes for puzzles.
Noah's Ark, right there. You switch the S and the H around, that's, no, a shark!
And hopefully, there is part of the day available for me to actually do normal things with the people I love.
Every crossword is a collaboration between the puzzle maker and the editor. I get 60 to 75 puzzles submitted to me every week. So, you know, I go through the mail and pick out the ones that I like best. On average, about half the clues in the Times crossword are my own. And I change clues, first of all, for accuracy and as a matter of style, New York Times style. But I'm also making the clues fit the intended level of difficulty. So if I've determined something is a Monday puzzle, I'm gonna try to make all easy clues. And if I've determined this is a Friday or Saturday puzzle, I'm gonna try to make everything challenging.
When crossword puzzles had begun in 1913, they eventually got so popular that an editor had to be hired to do it every week. Margaret Farrer wanted to do real journalistic things in her life, but she was told, okay, you have to edit the crossword puzzle from now on, which she didn't want to do. So she finally thought, okay, I'll sit down and actually do this. And by doing that, over the course of a couple of years, she standardized puzzles. It's amazing what we still use today from those days. The rule about 1/6 of the diagram can be black squares, the fact that it's all over interlocked, you can't have little islands of words separated from everything else, no two-letter words. Symmetry, the fact that if you turn a crossword puzzle upside down, the arrangement of black squares stays the same. And there's word choice rules. You can't use usually bodily functions in puzzles. You know, urine would bail me out of a corner, I mean, a million times a year. Same with enema. Enema, talk about great letters. But you got to keep those words out of puzzles. Because it doesn't pass the Sunday morning breakfast test. I mean, there are people solving on Sunday morning, the big Sunday puzzle. They waited all week for this. They're sitting there relaxing, and here comes, you know, rectal? I don't think so. As a result of these rules, she became like the first lady of crosswords. And when the New York Times decided to start running a crossword puzzle in 1942, she was the one they picked to do it.
We're doing a puzzle that is about the word wordplay. The way I thought we would get into the puzzle, since wordplay is an even number of letters, and crossword puzzle diagrams are almost always an odd number of squares on a side. Since you can't put it in the center of the diagram, what we'll do is we'll put it like this.
One of the great things about the Times crossword is that it's made by many different people. Each year I publish about 110 different constructors. And I think the puzzle is much better than if I made all the puzzles myself. First of all, it takes a long time to make a great crossword. And then with so many different voices, so many different constructors sending puzzles to me, I get lots more diversity. The puzzle wouldn't be nearly as good if one person made it.
The basic idea of this puzzle is that I wanted to think of words or phrases that contain the word word in a non-word context. And I wanted to think of words that contain the word play in a non-word context. I thought of words like Playa del Rey, the area of California where I used to be from. Playa del Rey starts with the word play and has nothing to do with the word play in English. And cross swords, as if in to start dueling with somebody with swords. Cross swords has the word word in it also. And it actually looks like crosswords with an extra S. So that was the idea, that we could somehow do a wordplay puzzle about the words word and play that did not involve the actual words themselves.
Right from the start, Merl loved the idea of making puzzles with as few black squares and as many wide open white squares as possible.
I've now put my theme answers in where they will go for maximum use of the space so that the diagram still breathes a little.
And now I'm just looking at it to see if the down possibilities have any problems. You want to sniff out these tough areas immediately when you're constructing. And the only spot I have here that's even remotely like that is this blank Y, blank, blank Y.
Right there. I mean, there are words that go in there, my way, pygmy, a couple of other things. But the thing is that this word next to it, A, blank, blank, A, blank, if all the ones I've said for here, this is a consonant. My day, that's a D. Pygmy, that's a G. So if that's a consonant, this has to be a vowel. And how many vowels can you think of that go A, vowel, blank, A, blank, and still we're going to bleed into this really important area so that words can come down? And the only one I can think of for this is a fragment, like by any. When I need that to be a vowel, like by any means possible, then from here, consonant, vowel, then almost anything I want. This is going to be almost anything. I'm just going to make sure that I can come down from here. So what I'm thinking of is that this is going to be a word that ends like this, and that this is going to be a word that either ends with S down here, or it can be something rather colorful, I'm not sure. But this is going to be like something like a G, and maybe this is going to be an E also. I just thought of something that's going to work nice.
Let's see. Let's do trysts. This can't be a U anymore. Is red top a word? Red top?
Well, I think it's a word, but I'm sitting in here. I mean, in a second, I would go near the room and look it up just to see. First, we'll look in the little dictionary, because that's where we want it to be. If it's common enough to be in a little dictionary, then it's... we got something. Red top. A grass grown in the cooler parts of North America for hay, pasturage, and lawns.
I bet you our lawn guy knows that word. I like this puzzle. Well, it's not one of my funniest puzzles in the world, but I think that it's... I think it's fine for a Monday or Tuesday.
Hey, Merle, this is Will. Are you there? I think this is probably a Tuesday rather than a Monday, but that's perfectly fine. And you know, if you would want to send me a few clues that are slightly harder so I can run this on a Tuesday, that's great. But really, this is just it's just great work. And so the answer is yes. Turn off your plans to do another puzzle, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
This is a Merl Reagle, and he's very, very good. He's one of the very best constructors, but this is a waste of his talent. He should be a Friday and Saturday guy because he's really so clever. Using Reagle on Tuesday is like using Barry Bonds in Little League.
My predecessor was 36 years older than me, and anytime you saw any modern culture in the old puzzles, it just came as a shock. You know, what's a TV show I'm doing in here? And really, puzzles didn't have that. My feeling was crosswords should have everything that's being covered in the Times. And of course, that's going to be classical music and art and history and old subjects like that. But it includes sports, popular music, movies, TV, cartoons, everything.
Why, there it is.
One of the things you have to do is just get rid of the rest of the paper when you do this, you know, because by then it's not important in your life any longer.
Can you find the hidden H where it's hiding? Is it on the ground or in the sky? Or
you always fold it over. You have to fold it over.
I gotta tell you, I mean, I was gonna do it in pencil, but it's Tuesday. Yeah, that's right. What do you think of that?
Sometimes we make our band members use pencils, I've noticed. Why do we do that?
Because we don't trust them.
Very bravely, I'm a pen guy, actually. It comes back to haunt you once in a while.
All right, here we go.
You know what? I'm so confident. I'm going to do it in glue stick.
ICBM is the first answer, and his clue is warhead weapon, briefly. Seems all right.
Warhead weapon, briefly? It's got to be ICBM. Come on. Everybody goes for that.
Warhead weapon. Got to be an ICBM or a MIR. Got to be ICBM.
This is probably Norma Ray. R-A-E.
She helped Theseus escape the labyrinth. Don't get cute with me, Will. because I'll come over there.
East northeast is 737 heading, perhaps, and he's abbreviated perhaps.
East north. East.
East northeast.
This is the standard crossword position.
Never on Sunday star Melina Mercury. You have to be old like I am to remember that movie.
You lean back, you put it on your knee, you fill it in.
Main arteries? How can that not be aortas? How can it not? No, it's not. Yes, it is. Come on! Bring it!
Cross swords to duel with, yes.
Duel with. Cross swords. And wait, duel with is cross swords, which is also cross words. So they're playing with us here. That's wonderful.
Dual cross swords. See, what you've done here, Will, if I may, the triple S. You think that's cute? That's not cute. I can take you with your triple concept.
It's wordplay. It's not too hard, but it's very clever. And there's the word play or the word word and all the big clues, like Playa del Rey. That's what's going on here.
Now, wait a minute. What the... Can you find that?